Today on the menu is an ingredient or a vegetable called chicory. I've never actually had chicory before. On the label of the pack, it said it is crisp with a hint of bitterness. I was a bit skeptical at first to try this out. I've never actually had it just now. There is two in each pack, so I cut it in half, and I think I might cut it one more time so that it would cook easier and it would be a little bit more crispy, I think. So let's lay it down like so. Online, it said to add some salt. As well as adding some thyme and adding some oranges, but I have easy peelers, so I think that it's the same concept. So thyme will give it a certain citrus aroma and it will liven the dish up. This isn't just a dish, but so for me, we're having this as by itself because I'm experimenting with different types of veg because you get bored by eating the same type of veg all the time. You get it? I said time. Okay. So we just want the leafy bits. We don't really want the stalks. They are a bit funny about how easy or difficult it is to get the leaves off. A little goes a long way, or maybe I should just be a bit more generous with it. Yeah, why don't I just put it all in? Have some of this juice from the easy peeler. I think this will liven up the dish as well. I think it is giving it like some sort of orange color to it. As with most of these vegetarian type of dishes, I also put some olive oil in to help with the cooking. So now I am going to put it into the oven at 200 degrees for 15 minutes and it should come out smelling fragrant and delicious. Well, this is nice and cooked and it's crispy, and let's go for the middle one. I'm not really sure what this is gonna taste like right now, but I'm really curious to find out whether I like it or not. It's nice and crunchy. There is a sweetness to it that I didn't expect. Let me have some more. So I can give you my full, some more input. There is a little bit of bitterness, but you don't really notice it that much. I think that it being roasted gives it additional flavor. And I think that the pepper really helps. I know before I said salt, I don't normally put salt in anything, but feel free to do so. I think it might help. But for me personally, I don't normally put salt in my food. But yeah, I think overall, the thyme does help spruce up the dish and the orange juice or the easy peelers does help give it some flavor as well. So I think this is a good side salad or like a side that you could have with any main, or you could just have it by itself. So I would definitely recommend this for anyone that wants to try something new. Thank you for watching our show today. If you like what you see, please like, comment, and subscribe. Everyone likes a snack. You do, I do, we all do. But are you snacking the right things? All right, so in front of us, we have 5 different types of snacks, ranging from different textures and from savory to sweet.
And my mouth is watering at the thought of it. Do we start off with the savory then, just as you would with a meal?
Yes,
we will. Although some people go straight for the dessert, don't they?
You would go for the dessert.
Yeah. So what's this?
This is Ryvita crisp bread, pumpkin seed and oat.
Ah, okay. Well, I've had Ryvita before. Crisp bread type thing, but not this type of one. Is this new?
You would normally have like a spread on it, but yeah. I wouldn't have a spread. Like, I would just eat it dry.
I'm eating it dry.
It might be too dry for you.
Okay. Oh, wow. That's tasty. That is tasty. It has the same sort of sensation as you get with a crisp when you first put your tongue on it.
It kind of tastes like wholemeal, I think.
So it's got all the pumpkin seeds. It says, crunch time, enjoy a light British baked whole grain Ryvita packed full of goodness.
I've had Ryvita before, but I don't think that they were as
tasty.
Yeah, because normally it would just be the plain one. But I think you need to trick your mind into having different types of tastes, like different flavorings.
Well, it says that it's 49 calories per slice. Sorry for speaking with my mouth in full gobby mode. British baked, no artificial preservatives, high in fiber for a healthy gut. Oh, my gut's really healthy. I want to finish this.
Yeah, I didn't think that you would finish it, to be honest.
Well, I do like pumpkin seeds.
Oh.
I do like a slice of pumpkin loaf at Starbucks.
They did say that the brain likes the crunchiness and the sound of the crunch. So I think that you would definitely get the crunch factor with Ryvita.
Shall we move on to the second one? Is it this? Is it a rice cake?
Why don't you read this?
Oh! This is from Calo.
Look, see?
And it's a lentil and pea veggie cake. Tomato salsa, lime and coriander. Made from plants.
I've had this before, but I just wanted your take on it. I've had a couple before, but I haven't featured it on the show.
Wow. That's strong. It's got a strong taste on the tongue, but once you eat it, it's not that strong.
So I have had a calo before, and the ones that aren't flavored, it tastes a bit cardboardy. But I think this one has like this this salsa taste to it, and
it's got a zing.
You also taste the coriander, right?
Oh, that's what it is. It's the coriander. Yeah, this doesn't taste like cardboard at all. This is a really good recipe.
Would you eat this then?
I'd eat the whole pack, probably. So if I did eat the whole pack, what would I be getting? Well, per cake, I like the idea that they call them cakes as well. Per cake is 41 calories and 1.2 grams of fat. That's quite a bit of fat for just one, isn't it? 1.2 grams.
I think that I've eaten half of it like in one sitting.
Oh, wow. Well,
easy.
That means that you will have had 7 grams of fat thereabouts.
No, but it depends what kind of fat it is. Is it the saturated fat?
Well, it says of which saturates only not 0.1 gram. So that's the good bit, right?
No,
that's the bad bit, I mean. The not 0.1.
Saturated ones are the bad ones.
Yeah.
The unsaturated, the polysaturated, and the monounsaturated ones. That's the good ones.
Oh, okay. I'm ready for the next one. And we're still on savory, and it looks like little crisps here. What are these? This is sour cream and onion flavor, Popped Crisps. And it is from Popworks. And it says it's 72 calories per serving of 17 grams. So
is it still fatty?
Fat per serving, it's similar to the other one, 1.7 grams, 0.2, which saturates.
The reason we got this is because popping it is more healthier than traditional fried methods. So that's kind of why I chose this one.
And it's sour cream and onion. It's one of my favorites. And quite a subtle taste.
It's not in your face.
Mmm. But the thing is, I think with this, I mean, I've tasted different types of, like, pop-type crisps before, and they've got more taste to them. The initial taste test, when you put it on the tongue, there's a little bit. Actually, this one seems to be tastier than the last one.
So maybe there isn't that many flavors in the one that you had
maybe
before.
Maybe we should shake it up a bit. To have another one. More. Mm. You know me too well. Here. Mmm. Well, maybe the salt or the flavorings just weren't evenly distributed.
Do you find that the healthier ones don't have as much taste?
No, not necessarily. At the start, you get that initial sort of like tingle on the tongue. But with some of them, I think with that one, once you start eating it, the taste seems to disappear. Whereas if you were eating a bag of like regular crisps, the taste stays. But it depends on the brand, I suppose, and the flavor perhaps as well.
So what are our thoughts on this?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't not eat it. I'm just saying that the doesn't seem to have a strong, long-lasting taste than the other two, even though they're different types of snack.
I think I like this one too, because I kind of feel like it's not as crispy, so it's not as harmful for us.
Well, that's
if that makes sense.
that's what you want to think.
That's what I want to think, yes. So that's what I'm thinking.
Time for something sweet. Okay. I think it is. What have we got here? Which one are we going for first? This wafer. Now, I've had this before.
Let me show this.
Yeah. You've got this recently. And
it is by Ciro.
Yeah, and I've been nibbling away at your treats, which I shouldn't be. It's sugar-free, isn't it? Completely.
So this is a sugar-free wafer with vanilla flavor. And
there's quite a lot of fat. That's for 100
grams.
There
is some fat, but the sugars is quite low. 0.5 grams.
Per 100 grams. And the fat is 34 grams, of which saturates 18 per 100 grams. And it's a 260 gram pack. Now, these are quite tasty.
And these are quite Moorish.
You wouldn't know there's no sugar in them. Mmm. But the thing is, you see, I could sit down and eat half a pack of that.
You could.
Oh, yeah. And I probably have them.
No, I like this because you get the initial vanilla kick, which is great.
It slides around as well. Look, it's very slidey.
I think that I've always liked wafers, but I think since this is sugar-free, I kind of like it more.
Have you had the pink wafers that we get over here? Have you ever had those?
We had stuff like that, like in the Chinese.
Right.
Like the Chinese supermarkets where you get the strawberry flavored ones.
Strawberry, yeah. I think that some of the pink ones that you get here, they're not strawberry flavor. It's just vanilla, but it's pink coloring on the wafer. Right, let's move to the last one, and it's a cookie. Again, it's sugar free. It's from the same magazine.
Ciro.
It says it's established in 1920. How come we haven't heard of it since the...
Because I think we were just buying full sugar products.
Oh, so we weren't looking for this.
I certainly wasn't.
So it's a chocolate chip cookie, high in fiber. Mmm, well, it sounds very healthy, so let's tuck in.
Mmm.
Not that sweet. Even with the chocolate chip, and it feels a little bit, tastes a bit dry.
I think that it's not that sweet either, mm-hmm. because they're not using all that sugar. I think maybe the chocolate isn't really the super sweet kind.
Now, it does say, so it's like cookies with dark chocolate chips, sugar-free with sweetener. There's a little star after the sweetener. And I thought it was going to say what type of sweetener it was.
Is it sucrose or something?
Well, that's not what the star is for. It says excessive consumption may produce laxative effects.
Oh my. All right, leave that to your imagination.
Say no more. But I think this is a bit more cardboardy. And considering it's from the same company as the wafers and they were quite sweet, I'm not quite sure why this doesn't taste as sweet.
Do you think maybe the other one has more sugar than that other one?
But it's sugar-free, isn't it?
No, but maybe more there's sweetener? More sweetener, perhaps.
Well, no matter, we have got empty plates. Actually, we don't, look. There's a few more bits there. You're going to say, you're not going to do that, are you, Marcus?
Yeah, you are.
Yeah, I want every last morsel.
So, what was your favorite one out of all of them?
I think it's probably
the orange.
Yeah, the veggie cakes. Maybe it's just because it's cakes. But this one definitely had the most flavour, the most crunch, and I think was the most satisfying. And I think I could probably eat all of these.
So. And the one that comes in second for me would probably be
the Rivita.
This one was pretty good, actually.
Yeah, I think I'd like it more with a nice bit of butter and a slice of cooked ham on there.
I think I might leave out the butter. I'll just maybe put some avocado spread on it.
So you see, there are healthy eating choices out there.
So whatever you decide to consume, just have these options in mind. And I hope that this will give you some inspiration for your dietary needs.